Go ahead, Gene. Wow.
Wow. All right, I just about got in the middle of this entire fiasco here. I don't mind telling you, that's the match that probably should have been taking place last night at Uncensored. As it turns out, it's going to be taking place in a few weeks at the big one, the Spring Stampede, Deborah.
That's right, Gene. You know, I would never brag, but I want to say here that I think Jeff Jarrett made a great Four Horsemen. Don't you think, Stevie? I mean, I love to prove all you people wrong. Now, what I say is the truth. And I tell you one thing, I am beautiful. And I am very, very intelligent. And I have money. And in the pageant industry, we happen to call this a winning combination.
Oh, yeah.
In a pageant business, yes.
Right. On that note, talking about a winning combination, you're looking at him. Some 6 months ago, when I walked through the doors, Ric Flair said I was the man that could walk the walk and talk the talk. And last night, Nature Boy, I certainly didn't make any liar out of you. So at Spring Stampede, Public Enemy, I'm going to prove to the whole world that you boys are down here and the Four Horsemen are up here on top like they always have been.
Steve Mongo, McMichael, they brought out the hardware tonight, so to speak.
Let me address you people. I dare you boo this lady. She got more class in her little finger than all you losers put together. And speaking of losers, Johnny Grunge, Rocco Rock, bring that buffet table out at the Stampede, baby.
Boy.
Mongo's ready to eat some Public Enemy tartare.
To gossip, and you didn't hear this from me, but Johnny Grunge, you know, your girlfriend really should be an artist. She is so good at drawing flies.
Get out of here. Thank you very much. Hey. Thank you very much, gentlemen. Tony, I don't know what to make of it. I do know in a couple of weeks they're going to be colliding head-on with the Public Enemy. Who knows what's going to happen then? Stay tuned for Nitro when we return. St. Patty's Day in Savannah.